Joseph Acaba is taking some time out to do some setup work with the Robonaut. It's the autonomous robot on board the International Space Station that's hopefully going to be used for some house cleaning tasks and some a little more menial task around the International Space Station that the astronauts will no longer have to do themselves. So he's setting up Robonaut inside of the Destiny Laboratory and setting it through some control paces as it manipulates a control board. He was also doing some transfer work from the Japanese HTV cargo vehicle currently docked to the International Space Station. And in just a little while, he'll be joined by NASA astronaut Sonny Williams for a educational event with the JFK Library in Boston. Sonny Williams, another NASA astronaut currently on board the International Space Station, has been doing some EVA checkout and procedure reviews for her upcoming spacewalk this Thursday, August 30th. She'll be stepping outside with Japanese astronaut Aki Hoshide. So today, the two of them were checking out the SAFER devices on their spacesuits. SAFER standing for the Simplified Aid for EVA Rescue, our kind of mini jetpacks that these astronauts wear should they in any way need them to get back to the International Space Station. As mentioned, the two will step outside of the Quest airlock a little bit later this week for a 6.5-hour excursion into space in order to replace a faulty power relay unit on the station's truss or the support structure, then also rigging up a few power cables for a future Russian laboratory module and replacing a camera on the Canada Arm 2 robotic arm. Aside from getting ahead on all of these tasks for that upcoming EVA, Sonny Williams is also working today with the SLAM device on board the station. It stands for the Space Linear Acceleration Mass Measurement Device and is one of the only ways on board the International Space Station to accurately measure a subject's mass, so the crew member's body weight, since they don't have gravity to just press down on them naturally. They use this device, which is a number of springs, that to generate a known force and then calculate the subject's mass from the resulting acceleration. Her EVA partner this Thursday, Aki Hoshide, has also been doing some checkouts of that SAFER device and going over the procedure reviews for that EVA task list. He was also transferring a few items from the HTV, or the Japanese transfer vehicle, currently docked to the Earth-facing side of the Harmony node on board the International Space Station. You can see the station's array here, quite a few visiting vehicles currently attached, two Soyuz crew crafts, and then three unmanned cargo crafts. The HTV all the way on the left there, the most recent addition to the International Space Station. Also, the Progress 48 is the Russian unmanned craft, and all the way on the aft end of the station is the European ATV-3 vehicle. Moving on to our Russian cosmonauts' activities for the day, Commander Podolko was doing a biological study looking at the veins in the lower limbs and the legs, which the legs not used much on board the International Space Station, so these astronauts serve as guinea pigs for a number of different science experiments to consistently track and monitor the progression of any weakening of not only bone density and muscle loss, but also the function and structure of the veins. So he'll be taking a look at those and then doing some routine replacement work on the Russian Electron oxygen generation system over in the Russian segment. Meanwhile, Sergei Revin unloading a couple of items from the Russian resupply craft, the 48P, and updating the station's inventory management system. Also doing the Russian Pneumo card experiment, which looks to study the adaptation of the cardiovascular system of these crew members while they're exposed to microgravity for long durations of time. So assisting Revin in some of that 48 Progress cargo unloading activities will be the third Russian cosmonaut, Yuri Malenchenko. We'll be, again, unloading some items from that unmanned cargo craft. We'll also be transferring some wastewater from one of the station's recycled tanks into the ATV's empty water delivery system. That ATV, which docked late March, is forecasted to undock and burn up in the Earth's atmosphere later on in September. Astronauts on board the station have gotten quite a few passes of Tropical Storm Isaac over the past couple of days as it's strengthened and moved into the Gulf. Right now, Isaac expected to make landfall late Tuesday or early Wednesday this week, eventually strengthening into a hurricane, expected to impact the eastern Louisiana, Mississippi, Alabama area. currently in the Gulf of Mexico, trending on a northwesterly track. This video taken earlier over the weekend, so we'll be looking forward to some more passes a little bit later this afternoon and also tomorrow as the storm continues to strengthen and form into a more recognizable hurricane shape.